In this session, we are going to see what is a charge sensitivity, current sensitivity, and effect of damping. In this picture, we can see a ballistic galvanometer and Lampen scale arrangement. Usually, the Lampen scale arrangement is kept exactly opposite to the ballistic galvanometer, and the scale is fixed at a distance of 1 meter from the ballistic galvanometer. Lampen scale arrangement is nothing but a scale is fixed or attached to a stand, and below this a lamp is fixed. From this lamp we can pass a light to the ballistic galvanometer. When light falls on the ballistic galvanometer, that light will be reflected, and reflected light falls on the scale. When coil turns inside the BG due to the flow of charges, the spot move on the scale either towards right or towards left. The spot will oscillate due to the oscillation of the coil inside the ballistic galvanometer. If spot is towards left, the first spot is theta 1, and deflection towards deflection of spot towards right is theta 2, and again towards left is theta 3, and towards right is theta 4. That is, the deflections towards left is theta 1, theta 3, theta 5, and so on. And deflections of the spot towards right is towards right or theta 2, theta 4, and so on. Charge sensitivity of a BG is defined as the deflection produced in the coil per unit charge. If theta is deflection produced by a charge Q, then charge sensitivity is equal to theta by Q. This charge sensitivity can also be defined like this. That is, the amount of charges required to produce unit deflection on the scale when the scale is placed at a distance of 1 meter from the ballistic galvanometer. We have, from the theory of ballistic galvanometer, theta by Q is equal to BAN by C into 2 pi by T. This is the expression for charge sensitivity. Now let us define this current sensitivity. Current sensitivity of BG is defined as the deflection produced in the coil per unit current, that is theta divided by I. This can also be defined like this, that is, the amount of current is required to produce unit deflection on the scale when the scale is placed at a distance of 1 meter from the ballistic galvanometer. We have this tau is equal to ban I, that is BAN into I, and tau is equal to C theta. By equating this, we will get this expression, BAN I is equal to C theta. Therefore, theta by I is equal to BAN divided by C. Now, let us see the relation between charge sensitivity and current sensitivity. We have this expression. This is from the theory of ballistic galvanometer. Theta by Q is equal to BAN by C into 2 pi by T. Theta by Q is equal to 2 pi by T into theta by I. I am writing this as theta by I from the definition of current sensitivity. Therefore, this equation is nothing but charge sensitivity is equal to 2 pi by T times current sensitivity. Now let us see the effect of damping. While deriving the equation Q is equal to C by BAN into T by 2 pi into theta, it was assumed that the total kinetic energy is utilized in twisting the suspended wire. But it is not true. Some part of kinetic energy will be utilized to overcome damping forces. Damping forces like air resistance, electromagnetic damping due to the magnetic pole pieces. Due to this damping, the amplitude of the coil decreases successively. If theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 and so on are the successive deflections of the coil to the left and right, then experimentally it was observed that theta 1 by theta 2 is equal to theta 2 divided by theta 3, which is equal to theta 3 divided by theta 4 and so on is equal to d. So theta 1 is deflection towards left, theta 2 is deflection towards right, and again theta 3 towards left, theta 4 towards right. This constant d is known as decrement, and its logarithm is known as logarithmic decrement, that is log base e. D is equal to lambda, or I can write d is equal to e power lambda. Therefore, this expression becomes theta 1 by theta 2 is equal to theta 2 by theta 3 and so on is equal to e power lambda. Now let us take one complete oscillation. One complete oscillation means the spot starts from here, from theta 1 to theta 2 and then to theta 3. Theta 3 comes again towards this left. So I can write theta 1 by theta 3. This for one complete oscillation from theta 1 to theta 3. This is equal to theta 1 by theta 2 into theta 2 by theta 3. Let us multiply and divide by theta 2. As we know that theta 1 by theta 2 is equal to d and theta 2 by theta 3 is equal to d. Therefore, this becomes d squared. D is e power lambda. Therefore, d squared is e power 2 lambda, where e power 2 lambda is the value of logarithmic decrement for one oscillation. Now let us take the value of decrement for 1/4 of an oscillation. So here that is equal to e power lambda by 2. If theta is the first current deflection and theta 1 is the observed first deflection, let us assume initially the spot is here and it moves towards left, then the deflection is theta 1. From here to here, the oscillation is 1/4 of an oscillation. Let us assume initially spot is here. If a spot comes to this end, then oscillation is 1/4 of oscillation. Again, if a spot goes to this theta, then 1 by 2 of an oscillation. Again, if spot moves from here to here, then oscillation is 3 by 4th of one oscillation. And again, if that spot comes back to the initial position, then it will be one complete oscillation. It starts from center, it moves left and then right and comes back to its initial position. Then I can write theta by theta 1 is equal to e power lambda by 2. This is for 1/4 of an oscillation. Here theta is equal to theta 1 times e power lambda by 2. Let us expand this. By expanding, we will get 1 plus lambda by 2 plus lambda by 2, the whole square divided by 2 and so on. Here this lambda is very small, therefore we can neglect higher order terms. By neglecting, then this equation becomes theta is equal to theta 1 into 1 plus lambda by 2. Now we have, this is from the theory of ballistic galvanometer. Q is equal to C by BAN into T by 2 pi into theta. Now let us substitute this theta as theta 1 into 1 plus lambda by 2, that is damping correction. Therefore, this equation becomes Q is equal to C by BAN into T by 2 pi theta 1 into 1 plus lambda by 2. Thus, effect of damping in BG can be corrected. Now let us see logarithmic decrement. So here the logarithmic decrement can be calculated by taking first 11 successive deflections. We know that theta 1 by theta 2 and theta 2 by theta 3 is equal to d or equal to e power lambda. For 11 deflections, successive deflections, we write this equation as theta 1 by theta 11 is equal to e power 10 lambda. Taking log on both sides, we get log theta 1 by theta 11 base e is equal to 10 lambda, or lambda is equal to 1 by 10 log theta 1 by theta 11 with base e. This can be written as 2.303 log base 10 into theta 1 divided by theta 11 divided by this 10. In general, this equation can be written as lambda is equal to 2.303 divided by n minus 1 into log theta 1 by theta n base 10. Thank you.